Annual Jalsa Salana that's been held in this country. We've had an opportunity today and in the prior days to talk to several of the members of our Jamaat who played a prominent role both in the past year, both currently as well as historically in the history of this Jamaat. And it is our privilege and with a request for prayers that we are able to present some of the conversations we had with some of the very old members of our Jamaat, some of those who are very, very active now. We'd like to request our entire listening audience to remember these people in their prayers, to remember both those who you see on the screen in their prayers as well as those who you don't, because for every person whom we've had an opportunity to speak with, there are hundreds, in fact thousands, who are working very, very hard to make this Jalsa, to make this Jamaat's activity successful, and it is entirely by Allah's grace that these programs are successful. So it is with a request for prayers that we will begin the program and present some interviews with members of the United States Jamaat. Jazakallah.
Actually, if we don't have the mic in front of you, let's start over.
With the grace of Allah, the Jalsa is going well, and I'm ingratiated by the good turnout this year so far. I think we are able to focus on the issues of Tabligh and how we are going to relate to the society in America. I hope we can keep our focus on that, and inshallah, Allah will show us the way.
Amir Saab, could you talk a little bit about yesterday's activities and some of the speeches and the sessions, any highlights from yesterday?
Impressed with the most about yesterday is the volunteer spirit in which everything is getting done. And with the grace of Allah, I'm seeing that all the different nizamats, they are pulling together and making this the whole event go without a glitch. And that to me was the most impressive. Whatever minor errors were there, they were fixed and without any rancor. And everybody was very cooperative and very enthusiastic in making the whole event successful.
Jazakallah. Assalamu alaikum. We are with Brother Bashiruddin Osama. Brother Osama is a very, very old member of the United States Jamaat. He became an Ahmadi in the early 50s.
1951 to be exact, in New York City. And Ghulam Yassin was the missionary in charge, missionary at that time, and Brother Khalil Ahmad Nasir was the missionary in charge in Washington at that time.
So Brother Osama, you've certainly seen the United States Jamaat grow over the last 40 years. Could you share with us some of your impressions on when was the first Jalsa you came to? How different is this event from the first ones you saw, and how has the character of the Jamaat changed?
Well, the very first one was in 1955. It was in St. Louis at that time. And generally at that time, we moved the Jalsas around from the various cities. And that way you had an opportunity to visit new Jamaats. Well, in terms of how it's changed dramatically, the number of various groups, when I say that, minority groups, has been increasing. Number two, the actual activities and number of people coming in has increased too. Plus the speeches, they're much varied than they were back in the early 50s. So it has been quite a eventful change in that regard.
Well, Jazakallah, Brother Osama, and thank you for joining us.
Thank you. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam. Salman Sajid. Salman is in charge of the web design team in the United States Jamaat and has responsibility for designing the alislam.org website. Assalamu alaikum, Salman.
Wa alaikum salam.
Could you tell us a little bit about the website? What are some of the services that are offered through the site, and what is your team responsible for?
Sure. The primary purpose of the alislam.org site is to educate, you know, the world about Ahmadiyyat, and we do that by some employing some very novel features. One of the things we do is that we have live MTA streaming, so that even if you don't have a dish, you could still go to alislam.org and log on and view it online if you have an apartment or even a college dorm that doesn't allow satellites dishes to be used. Another thing we have is that we're trying to get a lot of the books online, that everything from the philosophy of the teachings of Islam to Christianity, Huzur's Christianity book, to even little blurbs about the Qasida and about all of the Promised Messiah's 80 books are online as well. Lastly, we also have a site called AskIslam.com that aims to provide Huzur's question and answer session online in with real audio streaming, so that when you click on an answer, Huzur seems to answer your voice, your question in his own voice. So we're really trying to provide a new experience to a lot of the people who browse the internet more than just simple text.
Now, Salman, the Ask Islam site, which I visited, it has a good selection there, but the volume of question and answer sessions that have been conducted by Huzur is encyclopedic. It's enormous. Are you going to continue to expand the offering there?
Of course. Currently, there's about over 300 questions on the site, and by our calculation, there Huzur has done about 16,000 question and answers in his career or tenure. So it's as you can imagine, it's a very slow and, you know, arduous process, but we intend to constantly add it, and as well as new features, like having a natural language search function where you could just ask the question like, is Jesus the Son of God? And Huzur could, you know, answer you right straight from there. So one thing we'd like to do is request prayers, you know, from everyone, all the MTA viewers, for this big task, and just keep us, you know, in your prayers always.
Jazakallah. Thank you very much.
Jazakallah.
Brother Rashid is one of the very, very distinguished and long-standing members of the Jamaat in the United States. Assalamu alaikum, brother.
Wa alaikum salam tula.
Brother Rashid, could you tell us a little bit about your life when you became an Ahmadi?
We have to go back to 1946 now. 1946 is when I first embraced Ahmadiyyat, and that was because of one local Ahmadi brother who was preaching in the street, which preaching is so important. And by him preaching in the street, and that one theme he was preaching was that Jesus didn't die on the cross, which was something very new, because we were accustomed hearing about Jesus going to save this thing there, but now he didn't die on the cross. So it means that there's no atonement, there's no resurrection. So now life now have become something new to think about. So thinking about what's new, let me find out what's new. So that led me to the Ahmadiyya movement, and from there has been a study from this day up until now, from that day up to now.
And Brother Rashid, you've been to Pakistan, you've attended Jalsas in Rabwa.
Yes, I was there.
Right. Could you tell us about the first Jalsa you went to in Pakistan and some of your impressions of the Jamaat in Pakistan and elsewhere in the world?
The first Jalsa I attended in Pakistan was that during the week of that Jalsa, I arrived in Pakistan. Now, and after meeting the Hazrat Khalifatul Masih II, may God be pleased with him, he told me in my next meeting that I was like old news. We met you last night, so now there's no need that we should meet you again. So I should find something to do. We're talking about during the time of the Jalsa. So I went around doing that Jalsa trying to find something to do. And I finally found someone who would let me work in the Jalsa, and the Roti Taksim. And that was with the young boys, the small children, counting the bread, stacking them in piles of tens. So that was my first experience for the Jalsa in Rabwa, in the job of in the Langa Khana on the Roti Taksim.
And how many times did you go back to attend Jalsa in Rabwa?
Well, I stayed there. I attended every year it was there, long I was staying there for 5 years, you know. So every year I'm there, and since I've been away from there, I've been back about three times. But not working, but I only went back to visit, you know.
Well, please remember us all in your prayers, and Jazakallah, thank you for joining us.
Right, well. Thank you very much for giving me a chance to talk about it.
Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi. We're with Brother Hassan Hakim of the Zion Jamaat. Brother Hakim is president of the Zion Jamaat, which Ahmadis around the world know as the home of John Alexander Dowie. He's also in charge of publications for the U.S. Jamaat. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah.
Wa alaykum as-salam. How are you doing?
Alhamdulillah. Brother Hakim, you had a speech yesterday on the subject of Islam and tolerance. Could you tell us a little bit about the speech?
I think what I was trying to accentuate and point out in that speech is that the beauties of Islam are there for the world to behold. We're the most tolerant faith in the whole world. In particular in Zion, I use Zion as an example for Americans because in Zion, that is where the hand of God has shown itself through the promised Messiah, alayhi salam. If you look in Zion, you will see the best model of tolerance for America because the promised Messiah confronted Islamophobia in the form of Dr. John Alexander Dowie. In that city, if not the promised Messiah had confronted this man's very bigoted and very bad mouth behavior towards the prophet of Islam, there's no telling what would have happened in this country because he was a very influential Christian at that time. But because of the work of the promised Messiah and what he did in Zion, we are there today. Our mission house stands there today as a testimony to the truth of Islam and the Ahmadiyyat, as a testimony to the truth of the promised Messiah himself. And what we've done is that we've tried to start a good neighbor program with the people of Zion. We've been very inclusive in working with the people of Zion. The mayor of the city, the mayor, Lane Harrison, now has become a very good friend of Ahmadiyya because he has recognized the truth of what we are preaching in Zion. So that's our thing, is to let people know that we are indeed some of the best people. We are carrying the message of the promised Messiah, alayhi salam, to every person in the city of Zion. Not only that, but we are doing it with service to the people of Zion. We are feeding the people. We have a program where we go out with food for the homeless and for the seniors in that community. We are working with the youth of that community. Our mission house is just that, a mission house that works for the betterment of the community.
Jazakallah. Now, you've also done, there is a large function recently to commemorate 100 years of the prophecy of Zion. Could you tell us a little bit about that and some of the work that Jamaat is doing in terms of research and keeping alive and learning more about the history of that period?
We held 2 years ago in the city of Zion, Messiah 2000. And this was a celebration and an observation of the truth of the promised Messiah, alayhi salam, and what occurred with Dr. John Alexander Dowie in the city of Zion. What we did is nothing more than what our present Emir, M.M. Ahmed, said in 1973 at the Lake Forest, Jalsa Salana. He said that in the city of Zion, we should hold a celebration, an observation, to talk about the prophecy that occurred in Zion. And that's exactly what we did. For 2 days, we had more than 3,000 people, 500 non-Ahmadi guests and visitors who came to the city of Zion to hear that truth about the promised Messiah, alayhi salam. It was very successful, and as a result, the Jamaat has grown, and as a result, the name of Ahmadiyyat has carried in the city of Zion, and as a result, people have become very familiar with that model, love for all, hatred for none.
Jazakallah, Brother Hakim. Jazakallah very much. Assalamu alaikum. Brother Yasin, as many of the people in the United States Jamaat know, your family has been very, very active in the Jamaat for many decades in the United States. Your mother in particular, and Iran, who's now passed away, and their children have played prominent roles and very active roles in the Jamaat. You grew up in the York Jamaat, which was a small Jamaat but had a lot of converts. Could you tell us a little bit about that and how the York Jamaat is today?
Well, the York Jamaat is now full of life in the York and Harrisburg area, which is the capital of that state of Pennsylvania. And we have a very growing Jamaat. I was born Ahmadi, as one of the few indigenous Americans to be born as second generation Ahmadi, and that has been a great challenge and also a lot of rewarding things from that. And my extended family, I have three sons and two daughters who are new additions to the family, and we are active in our Jamaat in the York Harrisburg area. We have about 45 families now that grew from two families, my father's family and one other family that came from Pakistan and started our Jamaat back in around 1973.
Jazakallah. And how has the Tabligh efforts been in the York Harrisburg area more recently?
More recently, all the members of our Jamaat have become Dayan Allah, whether they choose to or not, because whether at work or at school or wherever, There are great questions being constantly thrown at us, and so we're all both in action and in discussion, representing the Jamaat and Islam in the best way we know how. Personally, although I'm no longer in the position of Jamaat president, myself and my wife have spoken at multiple churches and gatherings and social organizations about Islam to try to answer questions and just set a tone for what real Islam is versus what people are seeing in the media.
Well, Jazakallah, thank you for your time. May Allah bless your efforts, and thank you for taking the time to speak with us.
Jazakallah, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.
We're here with Nasir Mahmood Malik Sahib of Michigan Jamaat, who is both Sadr Ansarullah Ahmadiyya USA and also is Secretary Tarbiyat for the United States Jamaat. Could you tell us a little bit about the activities of Ansarullah Ahmadiyya in the United States?
MashaAllah, Majlis Ansarullah has the leadership responsibility to lead the USA Ahmadis, families and individuals towards the goal that we have. And we are striving in our humble ways to achieve that. Ansarullah organization is relatively new in the USA, but it's coming along very nicely. Over the last 10 years or so, mashallah, great strides have been made, and we are furthering the structural aspect of it and holding the regional ishtimas for Ansarullah to activate them. And we have monthly schedules, curriculum for their tarbiyah, their taleem, and encourage them to do tabligh. So a lot of activities, mashallah, are going on.
And in the tarbiyah department, what have been some of your major activities?
In the tarbiyah department, it's a tough challenge, and given our limited resources, mashallah, we are continually focused on the tarbiyah aspect. And at local level, regional level, and even at the national level, we hold various workshops, picking one or two topics that are rather sensitive but also very important for our youth and even the elders. So we have been pretty active and successful in that. The members who come, they participate in those and they benefit from them. But there's a lot of lack of information about the fundamental Islamic ways and values and so forth for the youth that's growing up in the society. It's a tough task, but mashallah, we're trying to get a handle on it.
Well, Jazakallah, and thank you for your time.
Jazakallah, thank you.
Assalamu alaikum.
Well, Islam, I'm fine.
So Bilal, could you tell us some of your impressions of Jalsa this year?
It's actually so far very successful. Everybody's happy. There's no problems, mashallah. Mm-hmm.
And could you tell us about what you've been doing during Jalsa?
Well, my duty is with Khidmat-e-Khalak Daftar. Involves helping out wherever I can, also with the Mumi office.
Jazakallah. Mm-hmm. And maybe you could tell us about some of the members of the team, some of the other people you work with.
Well, I'm my director in charge is Mona Naim Saab, and our Khidmat-e-Khalak Daftar is Zahir Ahmed. Some of the co-members are Muhammad Ahmed, Irfan Jameel, Luqman Ahmed, Umair Zubair, and some of the other members here are working for parking and Amumi office, which is Abdul Hai, Masood, Usman, Jaz, such.
Right, well, Jazakallah, and thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum. Abdul Hai Sahib, parking mein kaam kar rahe hain saal. Is saal to parking ke lihaz se kaafi improvement hui hai. Koi is saal to logistical lihaz se kaafi jalsa smoothly run kar raha hai. Aap thoda sa apne department ke bare mein hamare saath thought share karein please.
हाँ जी, एक्चुअली इस दफ़ा हुआ ये कि हमें पार्किंग की स्पेस अच्छी खासी मिल गई. हमारे पास कोई मतलब ये जलसा गा के बैक साइड पे खासी जगह मिल गई, मतलब वो एक अच्छा हो गया. यहाँ पे ऊपर और फ्रंट पे हमारा जो हर साल हम लोग करते हैं पार्किंग मिल गई, और स्टिल वी हैव बैकअप पार्किंग इन अ स्कूल, सो वी बी ऑलराइट, रन स्मूथ.
जज़ाकअल्लाह, थैंक यू वेरी मच.
अस्सलाम वालेकुम.
वालेकुम अस्सलाम. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuhu. I'm pleased to be joined by the Lieutenant Governor of the State of Maryland, Kathleen Kennedy Townsend, and by her running mate in the race for Governor, Admiral Charles Larson. Welcome to you both.
Assalamualaikum.
Assalamualaikum.
Thank you for joining us here at the 54th Annual Convention of the United States Jamaat. I just wanted to ask you a few questions about your impressions of our community here and how you've enjoyed the program today. We'll start with the current Lieutenant Governor.
I'm very, very impressed. There's such a gathering of people who learn to love, to care for others, and to preach a religion of peace. It's a wonderful ideal, and it's important to hear it at this time. all across this country and really all across the world.
Thank you, Madam Lieutenant Governor and Admiral Larson.
I was very moved. I had a chance to be, when I first arrived, to tour some of the displays in the first floor of the mosque there and to look at the message in more detail. It's a beautiful message. It's a beautiful philosophy. And the motto of love to all and hatred toward none, I think, is something that we could all, every citizen of this world, could use and could try to live by. And I was very inspired, not only by the kindness and the spirit of the many people that I was able to talk to when I first arrived here, but also just kind of the feeling that I get of the environment of this gathering. It's very, very impressive and as I said, very moving.
Well, thank you very much. As you know, in this state, we have so many people from so many different parts of the world. And it's our honor to be bringing a message of peace to that community, and I'm sure you visit other communities as well, and we just wanted to thank you both very much for taking the time to be with us today. It's certainly our honor and our privilege to be hosting you this afternoon.
Well, I think, as Chuck said earlier, it's our honor to be here. You've inspired us. You've taught us more about a different religion and the real fact that we all say God, but everybody believes that God preaches love, and that's what we have to keep talking about and keep emphasizing.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Well, where various refreshments are available and t-shirts. There's a Majlis Ansarul Ahmadiyya stall where some books are being sold, a book stall where quite a bit of Jamaat literature is sold. There's also a stall for Aleem Academy, which is a Islamic school opened by Ahmadis in the
annual United States Jalsa Salana. In this area, there are various stalls for various departments. There is a stall raising funding for various masajid. There is a stall, there's also a Majlis Khudam al-Ahmadiyya USA stall where various refreshments are available and t-shirts. There is a Majlis Ansarul Ahmadiyya stall where some books are being sold, a book stall where quite a bit of Jamaat literature is sold. There's also a stall for Aleem Academy, which is a Islamic school opened by Ahmadis in the Maryland area. The MTA satellite info stall, where Jamaat members can learn about MTA. And another Majlis Khudam al-Ahmadiyya stall, where refreshments are available in the hot weather that we're currently in.